So I'm going to take this little bit of extra time to let you all know that I completed comps recently, which was fantastic. But that means I submitted this slide deck while I was in the middle of my comps, so it might not line up with what I'm going to say today. I also thought I had 30 seconds per slide, but I have 15, so I'm going to talk a little bit faster than I normally would. But I am so excited that I get to talk to you all today about LGBTQ game design discords. That is quite a mouthful, but these spaces are incredibly important to me. So if you think what I'm saying is interesting, please reach out on Twitter, at Jeremy Dietmeier. First, why are these places important? So this is a roundabout way, but video games are art. And as art, they convey a sense of what it means to be a person. It conveys a sense of who we are. So in games like God of War, you get this idea of what it means to be a man, what it means to be a father, what it means to be a hero. And then in games like Donkey Kong 64, you get to know what it's like to be a family person, what it's like to be a hero, what it means to be a gorilla. And so the problem is, though, that these stories all come from the same sources. They typically come from straight, cis, white men. So we need to make these areas more diverse. To help with that, I started the LGBTQ Game Design Jam. The problem is that even though we made some really cool games about being queer, I'm not a game designer by trade. I didn't have the resources they needed, so I turned to Discord. Now, if you're not sure what Discord is, it started off as a voice chat client for gamers, but it then became a social media platform. It's more similar to Slack than it is to Facebook, but it's a place for communities to gather and share resources and talk to one another. Now, I also turned to Discord because I'm very interested in LGBTQ online spaces. We keep telling today's queer youth that it's going to get better, but that kind of ignores the fact that it's really shitty right now. About 60 to 70% of LGBTQ youth get harassed while they're at school. They don't think it's a safe space. So instead, they go to online spaces. That's where they find their communities. Most of these students are saying that their online peers are more supportive and more friendly than their face-to-face peers. So these spaces exist online, but they're not just places to talk about their sexuality. They're very intersectional, so they're going online and they're finding people who are not only queer, but are also people that have the same interests as them. So one of these interests can be coding. So that's why these places are important. They're these intersectional spots where students can go out and find out who they are, do some identity exploration, but at the same time, they can learn new skills. This slide is crap. So this is when I thought I had, this one shouldn't have been submitted, but I'm gonna highlight a couple of things. I'm going to highlight community building as well as making things. So one of the most important parts of community building is actually moderators and having guidelines and rules. So you think that you just kind of like police yourself, but that's not enough in these online spaces. You need to know what you can do in this space. Can I swear? Can I talk about my sexuality? Can I post memes? And then queer spaces often bring out the trolls. So within these spaces as well, how can we make sure that the people that aren't supposed to be there aren't there? So that's why you need a very strong moderator team. But you also need to have the moderators there to, as one moderator put it, it's my job to keep the baby gays and the baby developers safe. So when they're in these spaces, the developers are making sure that everybody in there is following the rules so that when I get pinged at 3 a.m. because somebody decided to ping everybody and my phone goes off, that person gets a warning, and then they get a 24-hour ban, and then they actually get kicked out of the Discord because they kept pinging everybody constantly. So these spaces as well, though, they're not just forums. They're not just spots to ask questions. You can do that at other places like Stack Overflow. They're places to form a community. So the best ones that I was a part of didn't just have spots where they were making games. They had spots where they could chill and hang out and kind of form these third spaces that allowed their students or allowed participants to talk about things that weren't just game design. But they also had to go beyond just community to creating. So within this is stuff, the next few slides are things from the Discord that I'm posting with permission. So they have people who are posting their art. It's very easy to post your art and share it with the world these days. But if you want to make a portfolio, you need to have some of your top work in there. So they post it to the Discord first, where it gets ripped apart, and then they post it again, and then they post it again, each time getting a little bit better. They're also posting their UIs. This is one that I helped test. They're also making games. So within the Discord that I'm part of, there are 6 games currently in development. Each one has the lead game designer. They have their teams. They're organizing everybody within the Discord together to make games from scratch. So the people are getting their skills, they're sharing with one another, they're becoming experts within their own field. So within these spaces, they're not just serving as a spot for people to learn about their identities, as a place to create badges, as a place to get feedback. They're serving as these spaces where they can come together and form new communities. So the goal is that through spaces like this, that we can have a new area that can connect people from their interests to their skills, and similar to how Mass Effect 3 slowly with each generation got a little bit more okay with their LGBTQ characters and you got to have a little bit more choice in who you loved, so can we in these spaces and the games that we're making. If you're interested in this stuff, please reach out to me. That's my email and Twitter, and thanks, guys.